Yeah, Dineasy TV is in your ears.
So pay close attention.
Relax, let me ease your mind.
Sit back and recline, enjoy this ride.
I'm about to get deep. You're now tuned in to Dineasy TV. Dineasy TV.
My very first time I lost my virginity. Oh my God. My high school sweetheart. I was in the 10th, she was in the 9th. Her name was, I don't want to say her name. I don't want to blast her like that. But people to know that know. Anyway, I would get good grades. And my mom would reward me. So I knew that. Even though I wasn't the best student, I could have been A, all straight A's. Anyway, I got good grades. So my mom would bless me with stuff. So I told her, she said, what you want for Christmas? Or it was my birthday. I can't remember what holiday or what. It was my birthday or what. I don't remember. It had to be Christmas or my birthday. I can't remember. She got me. I wanted a water bed. I was intrigued to have a water bed. I remember being a little kid and being at other people's houses and just laying on it. High, you know, you laying on that thing and just rocking. It's a smooth feeling. And I never forgot that. So when I got old enough to, you know, to get one, my mom was cool with it. Got that water bed, man. And so I was telling my ex-girlfriend, or my girlfriend back then, that I had a water bed and she should come over and check it out. So she was intrigued. She wanted to see what the water bed was. So we ditched school one day, and thank God my mom wasn't home. So, you know, we go do our thing, right? And I'm not knowing what I'm doing, man. I'm putting the condom on wrong. I finally put it in right. We finally do our thing. One position the whole time. I explode. And I just kept going. They didn't teach us that in the 7th, 8th grade about changing the condom after you have an orgasm. They didn't tell that part. So I'm thinking this thing, I didn't know I could have been a father back at 15 years old because I just kept going. She ain't knowing. She ain't telling me to stop. And thank God it didn't bust, man. And here I am, still don't have no kids to this day. And we were sprung like a mug on each other. We were sprung like a mug. I think it was both our first time, I think it was her first time. It felt like it was her first time. I know it was mine because, I mean, I did it before, but I don't count them other times, man. I count because that was my high school girlfriend at that time. The real funny part is, like, after we did it, before I opened the door, I looked out to make sure nobody wasn't out so nobody would see her. And then I closed the door back, and I was like, come on, let's walk out. Soon as I walk out, we walk out, my neighbor, father, was walking towards his door, and he was like, and he looked at me. I was like, hey, how you doing, Mr. Williams? Does your mom know you got company? I was like, yeah, she know. All right, I'm going to have a talk with her. I'm like, dang, man. So I take her to the bus stop. We get on the bus. I walk her, I walk her to the house, to her house. And on the bus ride back, I'm like scared. I'm like, man. So when I come back, Mr. Williams, I don't know, man. He must have knew I was coming right back or something. He was sitting right outside his door on the AC. He was like, I know you lying to me. Your mom wouldn't let you have no girl come over when she not over. You better have wear a condom. Or wore a condom, sorry. You better have wore a condom. I said, I did, Mr. Williams. All right, I ain't going to tell your moms, but be careful. Be careful. And I was like, whoa, thank you, Mr. Williams, for not telling on me. Mr. Williams, I thought Mr. Williams was going to snitch on me, man. Mr. Williams had my back. He was like, wear a condom. Make sure you wear condoms. Oh, man. I remember I went home. I mean, I went in the house, and I slept like a baby, man. I slept like a baby. Now, how did me and her, then we kicked it one more time. Let me tell you about the second time. So it was on a Saturday. I never forget it. And it was about 7, 8 o'clock at night. And I said, yeah, Mom, can you drop me off at my girlfriend's house? Because the buses at that time on that particular route, they didn't run. And she stayed a few miles down. I could have walked down to her house. She didn't really stay that far. Now that I'm older, I'm looking back at it. She only stayed maybe like a mile, maybe 2 miles away. I could have walked to her house. But I didn't feel like walking. And I asked my mom because she dropped me off to my girlfriend's house. And then right before I was about to get out, my mom was like, wait a minute, is her parents home? I was like, yeah, Mom, her parents home. Don't trip. It's all good. And she was like, all right, I want to talk to him. And I was like, yeah, that's fine. You can talk to her. I'm about to. No, she said, that's all right. That's all right. Just go. I trust your word. I'm like, whew. Because I was lying like a mug. Her parents wasn't at home. So I go to her place. And this time around, we were both more experienced. And yes, I changed the condom. And with that high school early sweetheart, she was in the ninth, I was in the tenth. We broke up over some dumb argument back then. And she wanted to get back, and I didn't because I wanted to get with another girl. And I thought I was going to, you know, so basically, we dumped each other. And I had my mind set on another girl, and she didn't even want me. So, yeah, that's my story of how I lost my virginity. Subscribe. Like, comment to Don Easy TV. You!